All right, gentlemen, we've been over the rules. Protect yourself at all times. Follow my instructions. Gotta keep it clean. Touch gloves and let's do it.
The moment is upon us. 155 pounds, ubiquitously regarded as one of, if not the deepest, toughest division in mixed martial arts in the UFC. They are all chasing that man, Charles Du Bronx Oliveira. Slight underdog, plus 115 tonight. First defense of his title. Against a man trying to complete his mission in Dustin Poirier. Poirier, the southpaw, is in red. Charles Oliveira in the black and gold, befitting a champion. Early right hand gets through for Du Bronx. Now an elbow from Charles.
Oh! Oh, Dustin hurt him quick. The power of Poirier. I mean, the guy hits so hard.
Woo. Oliveira with a good clean right hand. By Oliveira, and then a front kick to the body.
One thing you can't do if you're Dustin Poirier is load up. And if you're Charles Oliveira, you can't take too many clean shots, man. You gotta be tight, because Dustin will shut your lights out.
One thing that Oliveira does perhaps better than Dustin is he mixes his weapons up. It's not a one-dimensional attack,
yeah,
like right there.
Knees.
Knee to the body, throws a lot of kicks, and you don't know what's coming. It's very multi-dimensional.
High pace through 90 seconds. Already 25 connections for Poirier. Ooh, nice uppercut from the champ.
That's what I was wondering. How soon do we see Oliveira try to get a takedown? He's trying to step around here. If he can get his left leg behind Dustin Poirier, he'll start to circle him back off the side of the octagon. And this is where his takedowns come from. They don't come from the double leg. They're always around your body, and he uses his length and leverage to get you to the ground.
Look at that. Beautiful job by Dustin of adjusting. Oh, another knee to the body. Those are nasty. Just perfect timing with those knees, too. Straight right, front kick.
Woo. Ooh, and now a left hand.
This is what we've said about Oliveira, just so crisp with his technique.
Poirier back to work off of his jab. Two and a half gone by round one.
Ooh. Oh, good left hand by Poirier. And a right hook by Poirier.
He's hurting Oliveira bad. And now he switched to conventional to throw the overhand right.
Oh, big right hand over the top. He's in trouble. Oh, Oliveira's in real trouble.
Switch knee to the body for Charles.
Those knees.
Another knee to the body. And the pace.
Crazy.
My goodness.
Pretty good head movement there by Poirier. Under 2 minutes in the round.
This is a crazy high pace.
Short uppercut is true for Oliveira, who's already landed 9 times to the body of Poirier.
Oh, beautiful front kick to the liver.
Oh! There's a big right from Poirier.
Oliveira's in real trouble here.
Yeah, but you got to be very careful if you're Dustin Poirier here.
And he wisely welcomes Oliveira back to his feet. Poirier with a big, deep breath.
He's taking a lot of body shots as well.
Plenty of time to work. Look at this.
Crazy numbers round one.
Oh, beautiful straight left by Poirier.
Well,
and
Dustin's just walking him down now.
The power difference is huge.
Oh!
That one snapped Oliveira's head back. Charles counters with an elbow.
And Charles with a 1-2. And a kick to the body again.
Well, Oliveira's willingness to just stand in there and take these shots is surprising. You would think he'd be trying to get more takedowns. Poirier's landing big shots.
And there's such a difference in the reaction. Like when Poirier hits him, he gets stunned. But he goes right back in there.
Oh my goodness. Under 30 seconds.
Oh my goodness. Poirier's just cracking him. And he's lining him up for a big one. Oh, Oliveira caught him.
Oh my goodness. This is crazy round.
Crazy
of fight.
Round.
This pace is insane.
Nobody can keep this pace for 25 minutes.
That front kick to the body over and over and over again.
What a round, what a start.
Wow, that was incredible.
That was a crazy first round.
There's a right hand that really hurt Oliveira. Wobbled him, boom, look at that left hand. And here's a beautiful knee by Oliveira.
He landed a few of these, man, really good knees in there, but I think this one here might have hurt him the worst. Yeah, this little
right hook.
Yep, that's the one. That's one of Dustin's best shots.
Wow, those are lands, right? 56 to the head for Poirier in round one. Dia Davis, longtime boxing coach of Poirier, wants the straight shots here.
Both Dustin gave him a look. Dustin gave him a look in that corner, Anik.
Round two of a possible five, could you imagine?
No.
I don't see how this can go five, but I've been wrong before.
Oliveira's corner wants him to use more front kicks.
Well, that front kick up the middle is an outstanding weapon, and Dustin tends to stand a little square. Oh, my goodness.
When they're in tight, Oliveira does a really good job of landing knees.
Yeah. And there's another one to the legs. He throws them up high. He throws them to the body in there. Trying to drag Poirier to the ground here.
He's got his hands locked. He's going to take the back of Poirier. Poirier's not careful.
Not a man you want anywhere near your backside.
Oh! He's looking for an armbar. Looking for an omoplata. He's not high enough on the shoulder.
No, but he's trying to keep Dustin in close.
But he's holding on to the glove in an illegal way.
Yep.
You see the way he's pulling the glove like that? Oh, man.
Oh, my goodness.
He cuffed his fingers underneath the glove to achieve that position.
There was something to that position that made Dustin roll. I don't know why he would have rolled instead of just keep pulling the arm back.
Didn't seem as though Poirier protested the glove grab.
I mean, we'd have to look at it real closely, but in my eyes, that's what was happening.
What are you trying to do if you're Poirier here, Joe?
Well, either offensively, he's got to let go of that triangle. You can't get offensive with the triangle guard. Watch the chair. So we're looking at another cop. Yeah, it looks to me like he's holding it illegally. He's got his fingers underneath the cuff.
And Oliveira is happy to be right here.
Oh,
that's a big elbow.
That's a big elbow. With Poirier holding on to that body triangle, that's essentially
keeping himself in there.
Yeah, just a defensive position. Unless the only thing you can get from there with that is perhaps a Kimura, maybe a guillotine, but for the most part, when you see a guy doing that, they're just holding on. And now he's just got a regular closed guard. It's not really a triangle anymore.
And Oliveira wise to just grind all over Poirier with elbows, with his head.
But it's kind of shocking that Poirier's not trying to stand up. Oh, he got tagged again.
Some big elbows there by DuBronx.
You know, it's possible that one of those vicious knees to the body might have done some real damage. And he might not have the ability to scramble out of this. He's getting beat up here by Charles Oliveira.
This is no good. We have not seen Dustin Poirier controlled on the ground for a while.
Right. And in a closed guard, where he's just kind of hanging on. It's very unusual.
Still plenty of time with which to walk.
Oh, my goodness.
And Oliveira's landing some nasty ground and pound.
These are big shots. Oh, and another one.
Ooh.
Dustin's in trouble.
He's got to find a way back to his feet.
And he's not controlling posture. Now he's trying.
He's got to open that guard. He has got to open that guard to try to start getting back to his feet.
Something is wrong. because he's not even attempting to get out of this position. He's not putting feet on the hips. He's not doing anything to get out of here.
Crowd trying to get behind Poirier. Crowd control time piling up for the champion.
The crazy thing about this is, for Dustin Poirier, Charles landing these blunt elbows are better than him slicing across his head. Because if they start to slice, they'll start to split him open and rip his face apart.
Right.
But I mean, Charles Oliveira has really put it on Dustin Poirier in the second round.
And this is real punishment, right? This is punishment that's going to affect the way he can perform for the remaining rounds if he makes it out of this one.
Dean Thomas, your mic's hot. What do you got?
The only reason why I can think Dustin Poirier won't open his guard is because he doesn't want Charles Oliveira to advance in position. I think he would much rather just ride this round out, lose the round, and then maybe come back in the other rounds, because if Charles Oliveira advances position, we know how dangerous his submission game is. So this might be the lesser of all the evils.
That's a good point, Dean. He told us in our fighter meeting against Khabib Nurmagomedov, perhaps he should have been content to lose the round instead of forfeiting a position that resulted in the end of the fight. So perhaps strategic for Poirier, but a big round two for Charles Oliveira. Charles Oliveira has landed 31 of 34 attempts to the body. Corner looking for more where that came from in round three and beyond.
Right.
Round three of a possible five.
If you listen to the corner of Dustin Poirier, Dean was dead on the money. That's what they wanted him to do. They just wanted him to get tired and just don't do anything stupid.
Oh, my
don't
goodness.
He's
got,
look at that.
Look at the transition that Charles Oliveira made to get Dustin Poirier down. Oh, and he said he did not want to give his back. And right now, Dubronx is jumping on his back. He has got to change his position right now, because Charles Oliveira is the slickest submission artist we have seen in the UFC. Now he's advanced
this
too.
This was his UFC debut. You remember against Efrain Ascudero?
Oh, Charles is good here, my goodness.
This is his move. The standing rear naked choke is so nasty.
Oh, Joe, now he's hiding the hand.
Oh,
now he's hiding
man.
The hand, Joe. Dustin's in trouble.
Dustin's in real trouble.
It's under the neck.
He's tapped! Charles Oliveira, count him now, folks! Count him now!
Wow.
Charles Oliveira maintains the throne. He gets the signature win over Dustin Poirier. Boa noite, Brazil. Celebrate your guy.
And that is a signature win right there. That is how he does it. Look at him. He's so happy.
Charles Oliveira, my goodness, man.
What a journey this man has gone on his professional career.
You know, Charles Oliveira got the back, and the one place you don't want Charles Oliveira is on your back. I mean, this guy has submitted more people in the UFC than anyone ever, and he just did it in a title fight. And now Charles Oliveira has won the belt by knockout and submitted his first title defense. It doesn't get much better than that, and now has won 10 fights in a row. The dude's a beast, Joe. I mean, he kept switching. He kept switching. And then eventually when he got the top hand hidden, it was over. There's no way you're going to fight for 4 minutes when you can't find that top hand to get it out of there.
Amazing. Just amazing.
And he extends his records for both submissions and finishes. Both the top numbers in UFC history. The reaction from the Diego Lima Shootbox team. Macaco Patino, his longtime coach.
You help the kids like he do. What you need, he help you to do.
I would like to donate $20,000.
You want to donate $50?
$50? To your hometown where he's from. To somewhere.
Quer dar para sua cidade onde você é. E dou doação.
You pick where the money goes and we'll do it.
Okay, I'll let you know.
I mean, when the action's going on, it's the greatest sport in the world, and then you have moments like that. If you missed it, Dustin Poirier pledging $20,000 to a charity of Charles Oliveira's choice in his native Brazil. but you had to look far and wide to find pro athletes on our roster picking Charles Oliveira. Rose Namajunas did pick him, but there weren't that many people of your contemporaries picking this man to win, and he carried himself with an air this week that he knew better. Mission accomplished.
You know, John, we spoke about this, right? We spoke about the idea that the favorite came from those wins over Conor McGregor. And I didn't understand the value in those wins today. Not right. Saying Conor's not a great fighter, but he's not Conor of 2016. So Charles Oliveira once again proves he's the best lightweight in the world.
One final time tonight, here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean has called a stop to this contest at 1:02 of the third round. Declaring the winner by submission due to a rear naked choke and still the undisputed UFC lightweight champion of the world, Charles Dubronx Oliveira!
A lot of reasons why Charles Oliveira won this fight tonight. Perhaps chief among them, his willingness to walk.
You can't touch this. You can't touch this. You can't touch this.